Hi students, greetings all. Welcome to my physics class. Today you will learn Newton's third law of motion. Before you must have known Newton's first law and Newton's second law of motion. In both these laws, the force has been defined in different way. In the first law of motion, force is defined as this is a physical cause which can bring the change of the state of rest or the state of motion of the body. Whereas in the Newton's second law of motion, force is defined as quantitatively, means we can find or we can calculate the magnitude of the acceleration produced on a body when the force is applied on it. In both these laws do not explain how the force acts on our body. Whereas the answer of this question is solved from the Newton's third law of motion. So therefore, you learn in the Newton's third law of motion that how the force acts on our body. So whenever an object exerts a force on another object, the second object applies an equal and opposite force on the first. The force that the first object exerts on the second is called the action, and the force that the second object exerts on the first is known as reaction. See, there is a diagram for you. There are two spring balances, spring balance A and spring balance B. And the spring balance B is fixed with the rigid support, whereas the spring balance A is attached to the spring balance B. Now, when you pull the spring balance A, at that moment, you apply one action on B by A. So the force becomes FBA. Therefore, force acts on B by A, and this becomes action. And at the same time, same amount of force acts on A by B, and the direction of that force becomes opposite to that of the direction of the action. The direction of the action was towards you, that is FBA, whereas the direction of the reaction is in the opposite direction of you, that is towards the wall, and this force is your FAB. See here, the magnitude of both the forces are same, that is 6 Newton, whereas the direction of the action and reaction are opposite. Therefore, the net force acts will be zero. Students, remember, in an interaction of two objects, any object can be named as the first object. So now, I will show you the statement of Newton's third law of motion. According to Newton's third law of motion, to every action, there is always an equal and opposite reaction. The action and the reaction acts on different bodies. They cannot act on one body. Remember this. This is very, very important. Here, see, one example is given to you also. One man is pushing the wall. So the man is applying the force on the wall, that is your 100 Newton, and this becomes action. And at the same time, the wall exerts a force on man, And the magnitude of the force is also 100 Newton. But the direction of the force is opposite. So therefore, here the action is the force applied by the man on the wall. And the reaction is the force applied by the wall on the man. So therefore, for action and reaction, there are how many bodies involved here? Here is one man, another is the wall. So remember, the action and reaction acts on two different bodies. And the forces always appear in pairs. So this is what is known from Newton's third law of motion. Let us discuss some of the examples of the action and reaction. So first example is a book on a table. When a book is lying on a table, what happened to the book? The book is not moving. It remains stationary. Why the book remains stationary? Here, the force exerted by the book on the table, that is the weight of the book, acts vertically downward direction. This becomes the action. Whereas at the same time, the table act the same amount of force on the book in the upward direction, and this becomes a reaction. So here the magnitude of action and reaction are equal but in opposite direction. Therefore, the net force acts on the book becomes zero. Due to that reason, the book does not move. Neither it is falling down nor it is moving in the upward direction. See, the arrow mark is shown over there for the action and also a reaction. So next example, a man sitting on a chair. See, when a person or when a man is sitting on a chair, the weight of the man on the chair is the action, which is vertically downward direction. Whereas the reaction will be the force by the chair on the man. See, one arrow is given in the first diagram. This one arrow is shown over there, and the reaction is in the upward direction. So here, both the action and reaction are equal and opposite. Therefore, the man is not falling down. And see in the second diagram what happened. Second diagram, that reaction force is not there. Only the action is there. That means the force exerted by the man on the chair is there. Whereas the reaction force is crossed there. You can see cross is there on the arrow. So there is no force of reaction. So when there is no force of reaction, what happened? It has broken the chair, or the chair is broken, and due to that reason, the man fell down. Now in the third example, the motion of boat in water. Now when a boat is moving in the water, how it moves? The boatman pushes the water in the backward direction, and in returns, the water pushes the boat in the forward direction, due to which the boat moves ahead. See the animated diagram for you. With the help of his oar, he is pushing the water in the backward direction, and that becomes the action. Whereas at the same time, the water pushes the boat in the forward direction, and due to which the boat is moving ahead. In this example, firing of bullet from a gun. Now, when a bullet is fired from the gun, remember the force on bullet by the gun becomes action, and the same amount of force exerted by the bullet on the gun. that becomes a reaction. And due to the reaction, the gun recoil or recoil back. See the animated diagram, you will understand. One cannon is there. The force applied by the cannon on the ball is become your action. And at the same time, the ball also exert a force on the cannon in the backward direction. Due to that reason, the cannon is moving back. Next, motion of a rocket. Now, do you know how a rocket is moving? When a rocket is moving, remember that the gas is expelled out from the nozzle of the rocket. And this gas, when hits the ground, this becomes the action. And the same amount of force will be exerted by the ground on the rocket, and due to which the rocket moves in the upward direction. See there, the animated diagram for you also. One rocket is there. See, gas is coming out through the nozzle and it is hitting the ground. And at the same time, the ground also giving the same amount of force on the rocket in the upward direction, due to which the rocket moves in upward direction. Just see it once again. See, the gas is coming through the nozzle, hitting the ground. This becomes action. And the gas gives the backward force on the, or the ground gives the backward force on the rocket in the upward direction, due to which the rocket moves off. Next, motion of man on the ground. Children, do you know how do you move on the ground? Here also, Newton's third law of motion helps us to move on the ground. Whenever we move on the ground, we push the ground in backward direction, which becomes action. And at the same time, the ground pushes our body or our feet in the forward direction, and due to which we move ahead. See there, the action is given in the towards the ground. The direction of the action by the foot is towards the ground, whereas the direction of the reaction from the ground on the foot is given in the opposite direction, and due to which the person can move ahead. See the animated diagram here, how the person is pushing the ground in the backward direction by its heel. By the heel of this person, is the ground is pushed in the backward direction, and at the same time, the ground push his body or his feet in the forward direction, and due to which the person move ahead. So this all about your Newton's third law of motion. Thank you.